Glory to God, glory to God. I want you to take these prayer points very seriously. Reflect on them, pray them as many times a day as you can. The days are evil. You know, Paul said to the Ephesians, do not walk as fools. Yes, but as wise, redeem the time, because what? The days are evil. Peter said, your enemy, he gropes about. He roams around like a roaring lion, seeking an opportunity to devour your life. You can't afford to stay like a civilian in a war-torn world like this. You must arise and put on your old armor and fight. This prayer point, I really want you and I to really pay attention to it. This one I call evil causes. The evil causes of the enemy. There's always a cause for something. When people die, normally people ask, what killed them? In other words, what's the cause of death? The medical examiner that assess a dead body, they always try to investigate what was the cause of death. It was all orchestrated. What is the cause of the sickness? It is all orchestrated in the realm of the spirit. What was the cause of death? Was accident? Was it drowning? Was it heart attack? What was it? Cause of death. There's always a way the medical examiner try to assess that, examine that. They want to know what happened. And the enemy, they're always behind the scene, orchestrating, planning, causing, making ways to trouble the children of God, to fight everything that is good. Proverbs 26:2 says, it says, the causeless shall not stand. What is the cause of your sickness? What is the cause of the divorce? It was planned in the spirit. What caused the separation? What caused the family to divide? What separated the church? What closed? What was the cause that the church closed down? What was the cause that the church was divided? What was the cause of the sickness? What caused the cancer? What caused the high blood pressure? What is the cause? The enemy caused it in the spirit. The powers behind this thing, sins. That is your prayer point. The powers behind the scenes that are planning evil causes. What caused the child to go wayward? What caused the child to die untimely death? What caused the marriage to be aborted? What caused the man to turn against his own wife? Once he called the wife, now he's an enemy. What caused the woman to turn against her husband? Once was a husband, sweetheart, now he's an enemy. What caused the child to turn against their parent? The cause. What caused it? There's a power responsible. The Bible tells us about, in the book of Ephesians, we read about Ephesians chapter 6 tells us about the principalities. We wrestle not with flesh and blood, but with principalities, powers, rulers, authorities, spiritual wickedness in heavenly places. Wicked spirits that are just there orchestrating evil, bringing all manner of evil causes. Everyone that is causing evil to come upon you. Everyone that is causing evil, that is orchestrating evil, may the Lord strike them. That is your prayer point. May the Lord strike them, the cause of evil, the cause of sickness, the cause of pain in your life. Who caused it? May judgment fall upon them in the spirit. Everyone hired against your life to cause trouble. May the Lord strike them dead. The thunder and the lightning of the Lord is warfare. The days are evil, beloved. From the days of John the Baptist, this kingdom has been subjected to violence. Only the violent will take it by force. Yes. What is the cause? What is the cause of your pain? What is the cause of your tears? Where did it come from? Started from somewhere. Everything we see in the physical has a spiritual explanation. What is the cause? What is the cause? What caused it? What caused the untimely death? People die before their time. What caused it? Evil causes. Pray against evil causes. May the Lord bring judgment upon everyone orchestrating evil for your children. Evil. What was the cause? He went to a psych ward. What was the cause? What was the cause? He's mad. Walking in the street mad. What was the cause? What caused that? Oh, may the judgment of the Lord look at those that are planning evil causes. Evil causes. May the Lord's hand be against them. In the name of Jesus. This is another prayer point I want you to focus on. Jesus said, a man's worst enemy is that of his own household. You don't play with the worst enemy. The worst enemy is hired in the realm of the spirit. The worst enemy is determined to take your life. Either you take them down or they take you down. The worst enemy. And the enemy makes sure he plants them within a man's family. I'm not talking about your sweet, beautiful family, few nuclear family. There are families that you have that you don't even know that are hired in this spirit to work against your life, destroying your children's destiny, your destiny. A man's worst enemy. They are your family members. They are right there. You know them. You are families by blood. You may not even know their first and the last name. It doesn't matter. They are your family. A man's worst enemy is that of his own household. You pray against the worst enemy. May the Lord strike them wherever they are. That worst enemy that is hired as a canker woman to see that you don't have joy, to see that your star doesn't rise. The worst enemy doesn't want to see your happiness. Your happiness becomes your greatest grievance. When you're happy, they grieve. When your children are rising, they're shining, they grieve. Everything they see you doing something, building project, doing something to develop your life, they grieve. The worst enemy is there to take you down. The worst enemy, you must take them down or they take you down. It is an evil. Every worst enemy, that's your prayer point. Every worst enemy in my family hired against me. Remember, worst enemy could be even the one that gave birth to you. Worst enemy could be your father, your mother, your brother, your sister, your auntie, your uncle, your friend that you open up to everything. Worst enemy. Yes, it's within the man's household. It is your prayer point. Beloved, the days are evil. If you don't deal with the enemy will deal with you. So you might as well. The battle that you don't want to fight today, your children will also fight that. Somebody got to stand up and take their stand. The worst enemy, you pray them wherever they are, may the Lord uproot them from the land of the living. May the Lord cause every intention of theirs. May the Lord cause those intentions to go upon their double portion. May the Lord severely deal with them. May they flee when no man pursues. May calamity overwhelm them. In the name of Jesus, the name that is above every name, that I know how to strike them in that name. May fire proceed out of the mouth of the living God and locate them wherever they are in the four corners of the earth. May the fire of the living God locate them there and judge them mightily. A man's worst enemy, that of his own. Who is hired to assassinate you? Who is hired to bring untimely death in your family and your destiny? Who is hired? You also want to pray that, Lord, open my eyes. The days are evil. You cannot afford to fight a demon, a power, a spirit, a wicked person. The people that are around, you cannot afford to fight them without knowing them. Many times we open up to people that we have no business opening up to. And they become the greatest betrayal of us. Open my eyes, oh Lord, to see the people around. Open my eyes to see and to know them. Lord, open my eyes. You cannot afford to be spiritually blind when the battle is a spiritual battle. You can't afford. Pray that the Lord will open your spiritual eyes, will activate your spiritual senses, your sense of smell. Yes, your sense of taste. May the Lord activate those. Touch. All of your five senses you have in the physical is also in the spiritual. I pray that the Lord will activate. But you pray to God yourself. Ask the Lord, that Father, open my eyes to see the people that come around me. Let me know their agenda. Let me know their plan. The people, where is my problem coming from? Open my eyes, oh Lord, that I may see the source of the problem. That I may see the people that are coming. Jesus said, they're wolf in sheep clothing. They come as wolf. Wolf is sitting there. They capable of swallowing you, tearing you in pieces. But they come in sheep clothing. Fake is what they are. Open my eyes. May the Lord open the eyes of his people. May the Lord open your eyes that you may see who is your enemy. So that you don't go and open your heart and everything to the enemy. And they end up destroying you. That is another prayer point. Lord, open my eyes. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. A waster. I want you to pray this prayer also about the waster. The Lord talks about the waster in Isaiah 54:16. He said, behold, I have created a smith that bloweth the coal and the fire and that bringeth forth an instrument for his work. And I have created the waster to destroy. The waster is just there to waste your life, waste destiny. People die before their time. He wastes their life. Some loser just come there and take a gun and shoot somebody. Wasted their life. Good family, they're doing well. Waster, in the realm of the sea, they set up accidents with them. Waste that family. Child that have a bright future, the enemy just come. Waste that destiny, walking around like a failure. The waster, that's just their work they do. They wait for you to succeed. Or they can go before you so that you don't succeed. The wasters. The Lord says he's created the waster. The waster doesn't know any better but to waste, to destroy. Every waster hired against your children. Every waster hired against your destiny. Every waster hired against your children, your family, your business, your everything that pertains to goodness in life. Every waster hired to waste them, may the Lord waste them away. May the hand of God waste them. May the name of Jesus Christ waste them. May the power of the living God waste them away. Those that are hired to come against your children to waste them before their time, may they be wasted before they get to you. May the blood of Jesus waste them. The blood thirsty ones, those that are eaters of flesh, drinkers of blood, may the Lord cause them to be drunk in their own blood. Glory be to God. Let God cause them before they get to you. Before they get to you to cause trouble, may the Lord strike them where they are. May they be drunk in their own blood. They're seeking your blood. The powers, the principalities, the wicked ones in the spirit, they're seeking to take your blood, to divide, take you down before their time. May the Lord cause judgment to locate them before they locate you. Let blood pursue them. They want blood, blood will pursue them. The blood of Jesus will pursue them. They want to eat flesh. The name of Jesus will cause them to eat their own flesh. Yes, hallelujah. That's how they are. They are wasters. God has created the waster to destroy. John 10:10, he comes not only but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. The devil is not your friend. The devil is your enemy. He hates your God. You have no clue. You don't even have the magnitude. You don't have an idea of the magnitude in which the enemy hates you. As a child of God, you may never even be able to catch that revelation of how much the devil hates your God. You don't play. You don't sleep. The days are too evil. Redeem the time. Be awake. To what Jesus said, to what can I like in this generation? They are like children. Arise. You're in a battle. And you're looking around like you don't know what is going on. Arise. Fight the good fight of faith. Take prayer life seriously. Take your prayer life very seriously. Be determined. Be awake. The enemy has brought the war right to your doorstep. That good marriage you have, he's going to make sure he fight it and scatter it. The good children you have, he's determined to make sure they become nothing. To make sure some waste that come from nowhere and waste their life. The great future you have, he's determined to make sure that he comes not only but to steal, to kill, to destroy. That's his only agenda for which he comes. Amen? Yes. That waster, may the Lord waste them away. Hired assassin. Who is hired in the spirit? Who is hired in the spirit to war against you? Who is hired in the spirit to waste your destiny? Who is hired? They are called a hired assassin. They're walking around looking for somewhere to do evil. The one that is hired to take you down, may the Lord take them down. Whoever is hired against your children, against your destiny, to assassinate it. Oh, may the Lord assassinate them before they get to you. The strength they have to move, may the Lord paralyze that strength. Their serpent, their scorpion, their vipers, everything that creeps and move, their frogs, every living thing, whether they're using birds in the air, the birds that fly in the air, whether they're using animals, dogs, whatever it is, ships, everything flies, may the Lord destroy them, their ability to breathe, the life they have, the name of Jesus that is greater, may the Lord's name, may the name of Jesus dry them up. In the name that is above every other name, the strength they have to pursue you, may the Lord dry up that strength. May the Lord put them in their deathbed. In the name of Jesus, the powers in the grave that is fighting against your life, the powers on the grave, yes, the spiritual wickedness, may the Lord that has power to destroy their body and soul in hell, may the Lord God destroy them in hell. In the name of Jehovah, they fight against you. May the Lord strike them. May they be restless. In the name, may the Lord send them into desolation. They flee where no man pursue them. In the name that is above every other name, may God arise and let the enemy scatter. They'll come one way. In the name of Jesus Christ, declare and declare, they shall flee. They shall flee seven ways. In the name of God, will tear them into pieces. They shall be as chaff before the wind. In the name that is above every other name, may God arise and divide them mightily. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen.